I'm Jogendra Singh and you're watching Jogi and You. Guys, this is a really good looking complex geometrical shape and we have been asked about its perimeter and area. And we know that in geometry, a perimeter is simply the sum of all the boundary lines. And the area is inclusive of every single point inside the perimeter. So firstly, we come to our query in which we have got a complex geometrical shape with the help of which we have to find the area and perimeter of it. So, what do we have here? These are two sides AB and BC whose lengths are 3 and 4 units. After that, we have got this arc and it is said that it is a semicircle whose length is not given to us. And we have been asked to find its area and perimeter. We have got this little information with the help of which we have to get both the measurements of the shape. At a glance, this information seems a little lacking. It seems that with its help, we will not be able to solve this question at all. Let me see what I can do here. Okay, at the first, find the perimeter of this shape. To get the perimeter, we have to add all its side lines, side AB plus side BC plus arc AC. Let's replace the values of AB and BC with the 3 and 4, which means 7. And for the perimeter, we don't know the distance between A to C. But we were told it's a semicircle. This means if we draw this line here, then this upper part ADC will be a half circle. And this AC will be its diameter. Now, the diameter of this semicircle is the hypotenuse of this right triangle ABC, right? So now, in the right triangle ABC, by the Pythagorean theorem, we can write AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square. Just replace the values with 3 and 4. 3 square means 9 and 4 squares means 16. And then 9 plus 16 is 25. Now after taking the square root on both the sides, the square on the left side will be cancelled by the root and this will be AC. And on the other hand, the square root of 25 will be positive negative 5. Here, the negative value of under root 25 will be rejected because a side length will always be positive. So we will only consider its positive value, which is positive 5. And this will be the diameter of this semicircle. There is also a shortcut to find the hypotenuse AC of this right triangle ABC. For that, if you look carefully, the base and the perpendicular are 3 and 4 units in this. So according to the Pythagorean triplet, we can say that it is a 3-4-5 right angled triangle. So its third side, which is also the hypotenuse, will be 5. Let us now sweep out all these things which are no longer of our use. And now that the diameter of the circle is 5, we can find half of its circumference, which is the part of the required perimeter, which we initially wrote as arc ADC. And you know, the circumference of any circle is just pi times d, that means pi times diameter. And since this is a semicircle, we have to divide this by 2, just like this. Keep this thing aside here and replace the value of d with 5. 7 plus pi times 5 by 2, which means 7 plus 2.5 pi units. And if you want its perimeter in exact numerical value, then the value of pi has to be applied. Here we are using 3.14. Just calculate it once. Then after calculating one more time, we get 14.85 units. And this will be the required perimeter of the given shape. Now, let us talk about the area of this shape. To find the area of this complex shape, we divide this into two simple parts with the help of this line. A right angle triangle ABC and a semicircle ADC. And if we add the areas of these two shapes, we will get the total area of the given complex shape. So, without delay, we will write the area of triangle ABC plus the area of semicircle ADC. Firstly, we will take the area of triangle, which is half of the base multiplied by height. And then, we will take the area of semicircle, which is half of the pi r square. Because here we have a diameter, let us replace the radius with half of the diameter. Now, replace the values of base and height with 4 and 3. And just replace this diameter with 5. 4 divided by 2 means 2. So, the first part we have would be 2 times 3, which means 6. And in the second part, 5 by 2, the whole square means 25 by 4. And now, after calculation, we have 6 plus 25 pi by 8. And the final calculation is 6 plus 3.125 pi square units. And if you calculate it with the numerical value of pi, that is 3.14, then our answer will be 15.8125 square units. And this is what we had to extract from the given complex geometrical shape. How simple it is. So, that's it. Now, those who want a complete solution together can write everything by pausing this video. Friends, to continue with us like this, subscribe to me on YouTube and follow me on Facebook. And of course, like and share this video with your friends. So, that's it for today. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.